In this video, I will show you 5 ways to customize the CorelDRAW interface that will speed up your vector editing processes. We will add a custom toolbar and then add some buttons. We will change some buttons to caption only for easier recognition. We will customize a right-click menu. We're going to add and modify some shortcut keys. And lastly, we will save and export our workspace. Okay, let's get started. First, let's review where the main customization options are inside the CorelDRAW interface. So let's go to the Tools menu, click Customization, and here's our customization area. The 2 main areas we're going to cover are the command bars. These little checkboxes control how to turn on and turn off the toolbars. If you uncheck one and uncheck it, it'll come back on to turn the standard bar toolbar on and off. You just click it. And the commands area is the other area where we're going to concentrate on and show you how to use each parts of the interface in here. But first, let's start by making a custom workspace. So let's click on Workspace, and let's click New, and we're going to type in Speed Editing. We can type that twice just to name it here. And click OK. And then click OK again. Okay, let's get into our customization by clicking on the Tools menu, Customization, and then click on Command Bars. What we're going to do now is we're going to create a new toolbar. So click on the New button, and let's name this Speed Tools. And if we click off in the blank area, it'll lock it in there. And right now we don't see any toolbar. Let me drag my interface around here, and there it is, hiding right there. It's empty right now, so once we click OK, we'll be able to click on it. So I recommend right now leaving it just floating, but later on I'll show you how to dock it inside a toolbar. But right now when it's empty and you're just adding buttons, it's best just to leave it floating. Now let's add some buttons to our toolbar. Some commands I use all the time are the wireframe view and enhance view. Let me show you how to add those to the toolbar. Let's go to the Tools menu, Customization, Commands, and inside this window is where all the interface buttons for CorelDRAW are. And in this drop-down, it sorts them according to what type of button there are. So if you know what type of button you're looking for, you can go right to those areas where they're sorted, or if you don't know, you can use the binoculars. So we know we're looking for a View button, so let's come down to the View menu. And let's look for Enhance. There we are. It's right there. Just click on the button and now drag it. And when you see the little gray dotted area there show up, the gray area, let it go and that will add it in your toolbar. If you let go when that gray area isn't there, it'll end up floating and create a new toolbar, which we don't want that. So now let's come back into the window and let's look for our wireframe. Since it's alphabetical, wireframe is going to be way down here at the bottom. Let's click on that one and drag that one and see the gray area there. And when I let go and see the plus sign, that's when I should let go. And another button I like for my speed editing is I trace a lot of images. So I want, but don't know where that is in the whole interface easily, quickly. So let's search for it. So I use the clip art setting in the trace bitmap. So I'm going to search for a clip and click Find Next. And it's going to start searching all those buttons. And it pops up, and there it is right there. So let's click on that and let's drag it over to our toolbar. And we can click Close here because we're done and click OK. And now if we want to pull our toolbar out so it's longer, it will be horizontal now. And now we have already added 3 buttons to our toolbar. Great, our toolbar is off to a good start. Another thing you can do to customize your workspace is you can drag buttons from the current interface, copies of those buttons, to another toolbar. So let me show you how to do that. Another tool I like for my speed editing is the Smart Fill tool down here. So in order to drag a copy, you need to hold the Control key and the Alt key and then drag this button, and there's your plus sign, and let's drag it to our toolbar, and when we see that gray insertion point and their plus, let it go. Another speed editing tool I like as well is the Smooth tool. So and that's hidden under this flyout menu, so if I want quicker access to it, I can drag it to my toolbar to get quicker access. So let's do that again. Let's hold Control and Alt and grab my Smooth tool and add it to my toolbar. Now that our toolbar is done, we can drag it to anywhere we want in the interface. So to drag it, let's click on the name and let's drag it over here in the property bar. So one of the settings for the toolbars is it can be locked, or you may need to unlock it to move them around if you wanted to pull it back out. To find that setting, if you right-click on a toolbar and look for this check mark down here on Lock Toolbars, if you uncheck it, we can see this gray area show up. That means shows the interface is movable. You can adjust the and move the parts around. So let's grab on this one here and we can pull it back out, as long as the toolbars are at the lock toolbars is unchecked. So let's put that one back in there. And now when you add the toolbar to the property bar, it looks like it's condensing the tools a little bit. So we want to drag that out so we can see all the tools when the property bar is context sensitive and changes based on what you have selected. So let's grab on this little separator tool when you see those arrows, and we're going to drag it to the right a couple times to get it to show all the tools that are in that toolbar. And now our toolbar is ready to go. Another tip to customize your workspace while you're editing vectors is to turn your most commonly used buttons into captions, meaning their names, so you can easily recognize them. Grouping and ungrouping are very common editing tools, so let's find those buttons and change them to captions. So I have some rectangles on the screen here, but they're not grouped, they're loose, so I'm going to lasso them. And now if we look up in the property bar, we're going to see the group button. If yours happens to be covered up, you may need to pull down our customized toolbar that we made farther down so that they'll show up. If not, they're just hidden down in the little drop down below. You click the arrows and they'll pop down. So we can come to our group button and we can right click on it, choose customize, choose toolbar item, and then choose caption only. And now we have our group button changed to its caption. So let's click it and we'll group our items on the screen. And now over here is our ungroup button, so let's change that one to a caption as well by customize, toolbar item, caption only. And the other one next to it is ungroup all. We'll do the same thing for that one. So let's right click, customize, toolbar item, caption only. So in seconds, we have customized our workspace for quick access to quick and group and ungroup inside our workspace for easy editing. Another way to customize CorelDRAW interface is to customize the RightClick menu. In some older versions of CorelDRAW, they used to have edit text in the RightClick, so I like to add it back. Let me show you how to do it. So if we go to Tools and Customization and click on Command Bars, and the first thing we need to do is click on the Context Menu Bar. What this is all the right-click menus based on what you have selected in your workspace and the tools. So then we need to come to Commands, and we need to find our edit text button. So let's go to the text menu, since we know it's a text item, text command, and scroll down, and there's our edit text. So now if we click on it and hold it and drag it over to the selection area, we want to let it go into the artistic text selected area. And you can let it go insert it anywhere you want in this right-click menu, but I like it at the top, so as soon as I see that gray area line up here, I can let it go. And if I click off in the white area, it'll close that for me. But another tip I have is to add it to the page and the desktop part of the workspace as well. So the interface changed a little bit, so let me search my edit text again to find my command again. And there it is. And now if we drag it, and if I come over to Workspace and I want to insert it into the document desktop at the top as well, and then I also want to come back up, it disappeared again, so let's grab it. There it is, search for it. And let's put it into the page. And if I insert it there it is. Okay, and now if we click OK, we can test it out. All right, let's create some text to test it out. So let's delete our rectangles and let's come over to our text tool and create some text. And go back to our selection tool and we'll enlarge it a little bit. And now if we select our text and we right click on it, there's our right click that we just added to our edit text menu, right click menu, and it's easy to edit. And now if we also have it selected and we click over here on our desktop, edit text is available, and if we right click over here on our page, edit text is also available. And that's how easy it is to customize a right-click menu inside the CorelDRAW interface. Another tip for speed editing is to add or simplify keyboard shortcuts. So let me show you how to do that. We can add shortcuts for our wireframe and enhance view buttons that we added to our toolbar. I'm going to drag out our toolbar over here just because it'll be easier because it'll show up on the screen for editing for recording purposes here. So if we right-click on our enhanced button, choose Customize, Toolbar Item, and go to Properties, which will take us right into the customization options. And we're going to come over here to the shortcut keys, and we're going to click in New Shortcut Key, and we're going to type Q, and then we're going to click Assign, and it'll show that it's now assigned, and we can click OK. We're going to repeat the same process for wireframe. Go to Customize, Toolbar Item, Properties, go over to the Shortcut tab, and we're going to type W, and click Assign, and then click OK. So now that we assigned those, you can use W and Q to jump quickly back and forth between wireframe and enhance view. And also, if we look under the view menu, you'll see where these shortcuts are assigned. W for wireframe and Q for enhanced, all ready to go. Another thing we can do is we can simplify existing shortcuts to make them single keys. So let me show you how to do that. Let's go to Tools, Customization, Commands, and we're going to customize our group and ungroup commands to G and U instead of Control G and Control U. So let's go to the Object menu and let's find Group. And there's our group objects. Then we come over here to Shortcut Keys and let's type G and click Assign. And now we'll come back over here and we'll find the ungroup. Alphabetical. And there's our ungroup. And we'll come over here and we'll type U. So those shortcuts are ready to go. Another shortcut I like to add is in the page sorter. I like to use that and I like to assign that to the S shortcut key. So if I go under view to find that, and our page sorter view is down here. And when we click S to assign that, it's going to tell us there's a conflict with the live sketch. That means S is already assigned to live sketch. So what we'll do is we're going to click this navigate to conflict. And once we click assign, it will jump to that command and we can change that shortcut to be something else. So let's click assign. And now we're on live sketch and we're going to give this shortcut, call it, we're going to go Alt and S and assign that. And now those shortcuts are all ready to go once we click OK. Now that we have all these great customizations inside our CorelDRAW workspace, we should back it up in case we need to reload it anytime or if we want to share it with another user. So let's do that. Let's go to Tools, Customization. Let's click on Workspace up here at the top. And here's our workspace. Let's go to Export. And right now, since we changed most of these settings, we're going to leave all these selected. And we're going to hit Export. And now browse to where you want to save it on your computer. Give it a name. We're going to call it Speed Editing, and click Save. So now it's saved on your hard drive anytime you need it if you need to reload it for any reason. And if you do need to reload it, just come in here and click the Import button. And here's your file that we just saved, and you would click Open. And you would choose what options you need to restore from your workspace. And you can create it as new, or you can import it into a current workspace. And click Import. We're not going to do that right now because we already have it all set up. So I'm going to hit Cancel and Cancel again. Thank you for watching our video on how to customize the CorelDRAW workspace. I hope you got lots of good tips out of it. If you're watching this video on YouTube, you'll find a link in the description below that will take you to our tutorial page on the Discovery Center. Here you can download a written copy of the tutorial to follow along. You will also find other helpful tutorials on CorelDRAW.